Hello everyone, Lone Wolf Rick here. And today it's like I'm in Trim, Nevada. Actually with my wolf buddy AB who's running away here. It's like we're looking at just walking around the property here. We're outside of the mall. That's the entrance to the mall. And we're going to take a look and see it's like what the occupancy of the mall actually is how many stores are open, how many stores are closed. As we're looking around here, we notice driving in the Carl's Jr. is still in business. There's one across the way here, across the parking lot, but there used to be a Taco Bell right there that is closed down. There's nothing in there. And there used to be a Mad Greek restaurant where that blue and white striped roof building was, and that is actually closed down too. So the pandemic has taken its toll on a couple of the retailers just out front of the mall here. And so we're gonna go in and we're just gonna kind of walk around. There's Whiskey Pete's in the background across the interstate and see what we can find. An interesting note is that from 1989 to 1999, I actually worked out here. I started out working at Whiskey Pete's, it's like across the way. Well, I was the hotel manager over there for a few years. After that, I moved over here. This mall is connected to Prim Valley Resort, and I was the director of hotel operations of this property. So I was here when all this was built. When the mall was built, thank you. When the mall was built, I was here. When they built the golf courses down the street. And I was here when they built Buffalo Bills, which is across the way. And at the time when these were built, it was a really fantastic time. Business was unbelievable. Everything was bustling here. The weekends especially were pretty amazing. Yeah, parking lots would be full, over full. They used to bring in something like 200 to 300 buses on the weekends of people from Southern California who would shop in to visit and spend their money. It's a list of the map, but we're going to see if these stores are actually still here. We do have a crossway, but we'll see those in a little bit. We do have like a Tommy Hilfiger's and a Bath & Body Works and Calvin Klein down there. And a Tommy Bahama's here. But you can see all of these storefronts right through here are completely shut down. There was a Naturalizer store that shut down. William Sonoma store was here. That is shut down. We were reading an article before we came out here where they were projecting that in the next 5 years, 25% of all retail malls in America will be shut down. To me, that's a staggering number. I mean, it's so bad, these flamingos don't even have I was gonna say something bad, but it's like, don't even have any water to stand in, so. Thank goodness the tugboat's still working. Okay. Yeah, there was an old Navy over there that shut down. I like the street art though. The street art is nice. You know, these massage chairs, I will vouch for these. One time I was driving back from California,
yes,
and I stopped in here just to walk around and stretch my legs. And it was a massage chair. I actually sat in one. It's $2 for 8 minutes. And I tell you what, they really worked very, very well. I was very impressed. Sunglass Max store that's out of business. They actually still have all the display racks and everything. It's still inside. So we're coming up to the food court. The juice box is still open. There was a pretzel place right here where that's empty spot. That's gone. There used to be like an Orange Julius in here. That's gone. Maybe that, yeah, maybe the Orange Julius was right here. I think the pretzel places were coming up on that. There's a Charlie's Philly cheesesteak sandwich. That's closed. A burger joint's open though. Alex's Mexican food is open. There's the pretzel place where it was right there. I can't express to you how sad this really is. I remember the time when this place was just bustling with people and everybody was like praising Gary Prim at that time and would tell him what a great idea this was to build this and build it next to the property, which was Prim Valley, because it helped the hotel occupancy a lot. Express Factory Outlet, that's closed up. I would almost bet that this would be good for exercise. If you just wanted to come in for about a half an hour to an hour and just continuously walk, you got good air conditioning, and you definitely get your walking exercise in the mall here. This jewelry store is closed down. Rec Room Shoes is still open. Still leave the back door open, still let the dogs escape.
This artwork in here is really nice. It's just a real shame that they had to use it to conceal all the closed doors. Yeah, this whole stretch right through here is all closed down. You know, I'm not sure what the overhead is for the property owners. It's like that owns this. But all these closed doors just aren't good for anything. You would think that they would be making deals with people just to get whatever kinds of stores in here. You know, whether they were clothing stores or collectible stores or just whatever, you know? I mean, this is too nice of a mall. It's like, and this is like, I mean, it's amazing. It's like, they're like, I'm not sure if this was an H&M store, but it's closed too. And I'm telling you, in this town especially, if H&M can't make it out here, then this mall doesn't have long for the world. There was a Calvin Klein, it's closed. Yeah, we do see some lighting up at the front here of some stores, but this is just so sad. Give a shout out to Toby Polo. I like that piece of artwork right there, buddy. Not sure when they put that sign up. But obviously nothing's opening there real soon, so.
That's by Terry. Or Cheesy?
You know, I'm just kind of wondering, it's like, you know, as Americans here in the United States, and I'm sure it's probably this way around the world also, when you see places like this that are closing down, what are we prepared to do about it? You know? I mean, are we just going to become like internet zombies and just stay at our houses and never leave and just order everything off the internet? Is that society worldwide that we're gonna become? What do you think?
I'm in shock. I
think it's
just, that used to be the Nike store.
I think you're right. I know there was a Nike store here at one time. There was like a Neiman Marcus, like off Neiman store that used to be in here. That store was always busy. And our Apostle store right there. Well, actually, I take that back. It's like there's another little wing right here. And there is an H&M store, and that H&M store does look like it's open down this way. So I'm not sure if they moved maybe from a larger store to a smaller store or what, because that H&M store over there was definitely closed. It does look like there's a few stores open down the swing, so I'm wondering if they kind of had all the merchants move to a more consolidated area, maybe.
I think so.
Which, unfortunately, is still a real shame.
It's very quiet.
I remember a time, it's like these little kiosk stores in malls. People were paying like $7,500 to $10,000 a month for rent for these things here in malls. I bet they're not getting that no more. All right, so the H&M store is open right through here.
Michael Kors.
And we have a Michael Kors here. And a Viva Vegas store, it's like which we're in a lot of shopping centers now, where basically it's just Las Vegas logoed items, souvenir type gifts. And Kate Spade, New York. And then some more empty shops. We have a Levi's outlet store down here. Coach store is open. Mm-hmm. Hello. A quartz mineral store. So, yeah, so it looks like they did. It looks like they kind of centralized all of the merchants into one strip here.
And there's Levi's outlet.
Polo store, or I'm sure Bella would appreciate a Starbucks cup.
The Bath and Body, Tommy Hilfiger.
Yeah, so we're right back. Basically, it's like where we walked in at. If this is any indication of like what the malls are like across the world, I'm going to bet that 25% that they were talking about closing in the next 5 years in the United States will probably be true. Because I can't see them surviving. It's like with all of these store closures and everything. So Okay, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to put this on pause for a few minutes, and we're going to walk up to the front and see if there's anything else at a second. We'll be back to close down the video. So everybody stay tuned. All right, everyone, so we're going to finish up this video. We found nothing else that was open. This is truly a beautiful mall. Like I said, I remember when it was just bustling. That's the mall, and this is the foyer area between the casino, which is down there. You see some machines, and the actual mall itself. It's such a shame. Such a shame. Anyway, this is Lone Wolf Rick and by Wolf Buddy AB, and we appreciate you taking the time to watch our video. And if you would, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. That would help us out a lot, and we would greatly appreciate it if you would become a member of our YouTube family. Everybody take care, okay? Stay healthy, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.